That was pretty close. I was just resting, well, I guess not offhand, but I was resting it on my knee. Just sitting down on the ground, resting a gun off my knee. That was a poke. Almost got it, too. How close can you get without hitting it? In slow motion, watching back in the camera, I actually thought I hit it. I thought it blew right through it and dust come off, but it must have been just off by an inch or so. That shot was around 125 yards. The groundhog's close, that's why I brought the blind. I'm roasting right now inside the blind. And I know the gun is accurate. I just need to become more accurate. Just so you guys can believe me here, let me zoom in here a little bit. I don't know if you'll be able to see this. But let me just see right there. 83 yards. That's the hole right there. 83 yards. That little green patch is where the groundhog was. Well, you can see my little blind set up here. I wasn't sitting on the chair. I shot off the chair, used it as a shooting bench, just kind of stuck it out. I could barely load. I had to step outside the blind to load the muzzle loader, but the groundhog was right there. Let's go check him out. Well, there he lays. Not a very big one, right next to his hole. Not very big at all, but see, right up there's the blind, and it was clear over next to the hillside there where the other groundhog was, another 100 yards from where I'm at now, but 80 to 84 yards right there. Well, there it is, the first groundhog with a flintlock muzzleloader. I tried 1 year with Hunter in a previous video, and we were coming so close. I got this new Tennessee Valley muzzleloader. It's more of a round ball gun, so that's all I'm shooting out of it. And this thing is so accurate. And right there it is. Not very big at all. Let's see here. See, it went in right there. And it came out right there. Just a little bit about this gun. This is a Tennessee Valley muzzleloader. And 42 inch barrel, square rifle bottom. It's got a Siler lock on it. And it is a beast of a flintlock. Poor boy. There's two people I'd like to thank, and one of them is Kevin. Kevin sent me this gun, and you know, just as a gift. And you know, I personally don't have words to describe how much I appreciate his generosity. It's just amazing. It really is. And, you know, I just want to thank you so much for this muzzleloader. And as I promised, there's your groundhog. I also want to thank Jim. He's helped me a lot, you know, getting this muzzleloader set up to shoot right. And gave me a lot of stuff. He even gave me this hunting bag. You know, a friend of his made this, and he gave me this bag. It's an awesome, awesome hunting bag. And just helping me with the ins and outs, learning about this rifle. And, you know, it's absolutely unbelievable. I know it's just one groundhog with a flintlock, but I'm telling you, to shoot a groundhog, you know, at 80 some yards with a round ball, and I'm only using about 73 grains of black powder, and just a hair over 70. And I'm telling you, this thing is so accurate that I would have no problem taking a shot at a deer at 150 yards with this. It's just absolutely unbelievable. And I can't thank you guys enough for inspiring me, and just your generosity. It really is unbelievable, and I just want to thank you. And hopefully this isn't the last one. I'm going to go back up and sit in the blind, even though I'm talking right in the middle of the groundhog field. But hopefully another one comes out, maybe a little bit closer. But yeah, and this one here, you know, I couldn't even see the whole body. He just had a little bit of his head sticking up over the grass. And you know, that's what you have to do. Just practice and practice. You always got to concentrate on that front sight. And you know, when you get used to that flash going off, you don't even realize that it's there. And I really like this long barrel. Like I said, it's 42 inch Poor Boy Tennessee Valley muzzleloader, made by Mad Vance. And just absolutely incredible rifle. Thank you, guys.